Dear chess friends, welcome at the Royal Chess Channel. My name is Manek Mikulas. I want to show you a game between Giri and Ding Liren. It was Spanish. Castle bishop e7. Now white played bishop takes c6. It's very unusual move. Probably home preparation. Usually white playing rook e1, b5, bishop b3, castle, h3, d6, c3. Or also interesting is rook e1, b5, bishop b3, castle, h3, bishop b7, d3, d5. Black sacrifice pawn. Oh, last years white didn't play rook e1, play d3, and also this is interesting, or this position. But white played bishop takes c6, black played d takes c6. Possible is b takes c6, but it's not very good because knight takes e4, knight takes e5, knight takes e4, now rook e1. Looks queen g4, that white is winning because attacking pawn on g7 and knight on e4. But after knight g5, black is okay. If white don't play f4, for example, queen g3, black just castle and position is okay. But after b takes c6, knight takes e5, knight takes e4, white a simple move, rook e1. And now question is where can black knight go? So, for example, knight f4, knight f6, d4, castle c4. White is better because black cannot play d6 because white just take on c6 and queen is hanging and bishop on e7. So white is much better. For example, c5, d5. Okay, let's go back to the game. Black played d takes c6, d3, bishop d6. Also possible is knight d7. This position is equal, maybe a little better for white. Okay, black played bishop d6, knight bd2. Bishop e6. Now white played knight b3. At this moment, both players play very quick. White spent one minute, black 13. For example, why not knight g5? Knight g5 is not very good because black just played bishop g4. After f3, bishop d7, and now black threatening h6, and after knight h3, for example, rook e1, black just take knight, a very good position. So after bishop g4, maybe white should go back knight f3, but so knight g5 doesn't make sense, so white play knight b3, queen e7, knight a5. Strong move because attacking two pawns on b7 and c6, and black had to decide play long castle or not. Possible is rook b8, But black player long castle. White play queen e2. And black played bishop g4. Also interesting is bishop b4. But after knight c4, attacking pawn on e5. This position is better for white. Okay, let's go back to the game. Bishop g4. White play c3. Planning b4, bishop b3, some attack. Black play c5 is not the best move. I think better is rook a g8. And now black wants g5, knight f4, and attacking. So this position should be okay. So rook g8 was better move. Why I don't have to play b4, maybe a4, but black should be okay this position. Okay, black play c5. White play a3. Possible was pawn sacrifice b4. Rook b1. Attacking b7. Black cannot take on c3 because this position is very good for white. Is winning because queen takes a6 and is almost mate. But rook b1, black can play knight h5. And this position is also better for white. B7 is hanging. But even a3 is okay. C6, b4, bishop c7, knight b3. Of course, b takes c5 is mistake because bishop takes a5. Knight b3, black played knight d7. Interesting was queen d6. And now, why is pawn more, but position is unclear because now black planning f5 and for example h3 doesn't work because blackjack take. And what can white do? For example, king f1 f5, king f1 f5, and this position is also unclear. Possible was queen d6, but also knight d7 is not bad move. White played h3, black played bishop h5. Also possible was bishop e6. This position is also unclear, or h6. Again, unclear. Okay, let's go back to the game. H3, bishop h5, bishop e3. And now black think like 10 minutes and play f5. Very aggressive move. What can white do now? White play bishop takes c5. E takes f5 is not very good because black just played c4, attacking knight and pawn on d3. If a white take, black play e4 and winning knight on f3 because knight cannot go because queen is hanging on e2. So after f5, black white has to have to play Bishop takes c5. Black play queen f7. Also possible is knight takes c5, knight takes c5, g6. Black is pawn down, but it's pawn down, but has two bishops. But after queen f7, more pieces at the board and more contraplay. So queen f7, rook ab1. Black play g5. Better was f takes e4, and this position I think black will take on f3, and position is okay. So let's go back g5. Okay, f takes e4, possible is queen takes e4, but knight f6, queen f5 check. This is also okay for black. Let's go back to the game. g5, e takes f5, g4. This is mistake, because at this position, knight g5, queen takes f5, h4. White is much better. Okay, but after queen takes f5, this position should be equal, or rook d2. So g5 mistake, probably black didn't see queen takes a5, queen takes f5, h4, b6. White now sacrifice piece and play knight e4. I think this black didn't see or calculate that is okay for him. So also possible was bishop e3, knight f6, d4, attacking pawn on a6. This is also very strong attack, and position is threatening mate, but check, and position is winning. For example, bishop f4, if black takes, is mate. So after knight e4, black position is very unpleasant. So black took bishop on c5, b takes c5, knight f6. Possible was knight b8, but queen b2, and this position is also losing because threatening mate on b8. And this is winning. And the game happened knight f6, knight d6. Black has to take with, also black took with bishop, but if he takes, if black take with rook, is also winning position because white attack is very strong. Okay, black took with bishop, c takes d6, rook takes d6, d4, a6 is hanging. Now black play rook e8, after queen c4 resign. For example, king d8, this is winning. Check, and is winning position. Also after queen c4, rook c6, d5, black is losing because check and threatening rook b8 mate, so is winning position. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.